Okay, we're going to go over some things that I use for snake hunting in Pennsylvania. This can go pretty much with everyone around the country. The very first thing I recommend is a must-have snake-proof boots. I'm not brand specific. My last pair of boots lasted me getting close to 10 years, but they started to leak within the third year. So if you're going to look for reviews, look to see how long they last for waterproofing. I just got those ones this year. You just want something that goes almost up to your knee, snake boots. If you're a beginner, I definitely recommend you get a pair of snake-proof chaps, ones that go up to your thighs, not gaiters, because there's so many times that I've been hunting where I fell down into rock rubbles, and I had snakes buzzing right here, right behind my upper thigh. So these were just for added protection. Also, you can just use these for brush pants. After I've had some experience with what I'm doing, and I'm very cautious of what I'm doing, I just use the snake boots, but I really highly recommend if you're starting off to have boots and chaps. The next thing you're gonna want is a backpack, because if you do catch a snake, you're gonna wanna be able to haul it out of there, keep some water and everything else in there. I want to bring a pillow sack, because that's how I carry it. I just drop the snake down in there, twist it, tie it in a big knot, and I can carry that snake all day long in my backpack. The next thing is a pair of tongs. There you can kind of see how long they are from if this was my leg here. That's about as short as you want it. If you can get them longer, buy heavy duty. Don't buy anything cheap on those, because they will break if you buy the cheaper ones. And this one here is actually four snakes. You can see how that doesn't close the whole way. If you're really wanting to handle the snakes safer, you'll want one of these specially designed for snakes. Now, the problem with these is copperheads and small snakes can slip through those pretty easily. So beware of that. Next thing you know, this is just one of these little snake prevention bite kits. You know, these are like little suction cups here that you could put on. Is this going to save your life? I don't know. If you're going to get bit, you're going to be in a lot of trouble. But anything that can help you is, you know, why not keep it with you? It might only cost a dollar. Now, this is what I get so many comments about. This is actually a fluorescent light tube guard. And I cut it to the size that I want. Now, it's only maybe 1¼ to 1½, somewhere around there. So copperheads will not be able to be used in this, or very small rattlesnakes. They will turn their heads back in this hole and start to try to come out. So when you get their head worked up in that hole, you can grab a hold of them right here, keep them from slipping out. I've seen guys, Shane, he put markers on here so you could see how many inches the snake is up inside the tube when you're measuring. Very safe. They're lightweight, very thin, but you do not have to worry about those snakes biting through this, because they can't turn their head to even try to bite through this when their head's up in there. Now, the problem is very, very big snakes will only go in that tube a short distance, because the timber rattlesnake has a small head that can fit in this tube. If you're out west and you're hunting diamondbacks, okay, I do not recommend these, because the end of the tube is probably too small for their heads. But for the timber rattlesnake, they can get up in there so far, but big fat snakes will stop short. And really small snakes will either turn around or go the whole way through. But the average decent size snake that you're gonna, let's say the average snake is gonna be perfect for this tube. So I highly recommend, they only cost a couple bucks at your local hardware store. I've been using them for years and years. And that's what I tell everybody, just go to the hardware store. And that's what I believe that they are used for. I just saw them one time, like $2, and it's like, oh, I'll grab one, cut it in half, and you know, they're durable, rugged, and just throw them in your backpack, and that's it. So that's what I use for snake hunting in Pennsylvania.
Body.
Yeah. Well, that's pretty good. Just they're all getting close to being legal, but not quite. I